On March 30th of 2014, I learned that a piece of me died that day. Now, I don't literally mean that I literally died. Of course, that never happened. And I also mean that, I don't mean that, a piece of my body died and stopped working. What I mean is a piece of my childhood, a piece of my teenage years had gone out of business, went out of business for the last time on March 30th of 2014. As a lot of you know, I grew up in the High Point area, High Point, North Carolina area. All of my life until my 30th birthday when I moved to where I currently live in Southwest Virginia. During my 30-year time in High Point, I spent a lot of time at the local roller skating rink, the High Point roller rink. At the time there was two roller skating rinks, one on the south end of town near me, and the one on the north end of town, which was the roller rink. Now, I know that I could have gone to the one that was on the south end of town closer to me, but the High Point roller rink was the one where everyone went to. It was the best roller rink in town. And so, of course, it's where I first learned to skate. It's where many a millennial kids went, learned to skate, hang out, spend their mother and father's money on cheap food from the snack bar and the quarter arcade games, which, to be honest with you, they had some of the best video games there. And to even get out on the skate floor and learn to roll and stop and brake with that big old heel thing on the front. To learn where we fell flat on our butts and came home with bruises that looked like our mama and daddies had beat us alive. It's where I fractured an elbow, or actually didn't fracture an elbow. I kind of cracked a little part of my elbow, probably when I was about 13, because I fell wrong and I went like that, and it hurt like hell for, oh, a good 4 months. Even today, it still kind of hurts. It's also where I got my very first kiss, which was a very memorable experience for me of 13, probably about 2 months before I fell and did some damage to my elbow. But I had my very first kiss there. And story of that, cute little story of that was every Friday night, Saturday morning, they would have all skate. Where they would let anyone come in and skate, and it used to cost just a dollar. It cost a dollar to get into that place, and you could spend anywhere between 4, 5, 6 hours in there just skating and listening to music and playing video games and eating greasy food from the snack bar. And Yeah, what can you do for a dollar these days? Not much. Can't do a lot for a dollar these days. But anyway, it was a typical Friday night, and I had my eye on a girl that I went to church with at the time, and I knew she would be there because she was always there every Friday night, just like I was there the majority of the night. So I had, it's probably the reason that I went so much was because of this girl. I was so obsessed with her. But I got up my nerve to whenever couples gate come around, or when a couples gate come around, and I went up to her and I stumbled my way to her and I said, "Would you couples gate with me? I need would you couples gate with me?" And surprisingly, that was one of the times in my moment in my life where I didn't turn into Jerry Lewis like I usually did around females. I didn't go, "Hello, ladies, will you go couple skate with me? I didn't do that. I was pretty confident and said, "Hey, would you couple skate with me?" She said, "Yeah, sure, I'll couple skate with you." And surprisingly, even though I couldn't skate very well at the time, I was just starting to learn then. I probably couldn't do nearly as good now as I did then. If I even tried, I probably would fall flat on my butt or flat on my face or flat somewhere else that I'd rather not talk about. It was surprisingly easy. And I think it was easy because I had a pretty lady, a pretty girl, and I shouldn't say lady because she wasn't a lady at the time either. And I was nowhere a gentleman. I was a 13-year-old kid, awkward 13-year-old kid. But it was very easy for me to skate then because I had her on my side and she was pretty much holding on to me. The whole time and kind of guiding me around the rink, and I think that I probably picked up some of my best skating moves because of that, having someone hold me and let me just figure out where my feet need to go and how I needed to go. But I learned that in a song, I was usually good if I could get around the rink around three times, and I would always make it a goal to try to get it more than three times. But because I know some people, there would be some people, it's all they bypass me. They just go. And they'd get around that rink faster than lightning. But surprisingly, whenever the song got over and we got off the rink, before she left my side, she looked over at me and went and kissed me right. Kissed me right on the cheek, and I just kind of just stood there like, "Oh my God, what the frick just happened?" I just got kissed by a pretty girl. Pretty girl kissed me, and. I mean, I know that that's a silly thing, but it's something that happened, and it's something that meant a lot to me in my life. And for a place that had been around for 60 years in a major town like that, I'm sure there was probably a lot of memories at that place, and probably still will be a lot of memories at that place. Also know that because of that place, a local native of the area went on to be a national speed skating championship and won a medal in one of the Olympics because of her speed skating, and because of her speed skating went on to ice skating, and her last name was Williams. I remember that. I don't remember her first name. Matter of fact, 'cause I never even met the lady. I'm looking back here at an article trying to find out what the girl's name was because it was on here. Here it is, Heather Richardson of the High Point area. Now a member of the U.S. speed skating team and two-time Olympian. That came out of that area. I just wanted to get on here and talk a little bit about my memories of that place. And if you'd like to read a little bit about the High Point Roller Rink and its 60-year anniversary and its closing yesterday, I'm gonna put a link down there. If you happen to be from the High Point area or know where the High Point Roller Rink used to be, please feel free to say anything that you'd like. If you want to talk a little bit about your memories of skating when you was a little kid, go ahead and do so. I'd love to hear them. But just remember, if you like this video, please comment, like, and subscribe, and we'll see one later. Bye.